All right, we're going to try to resume our conversation about the devastating slaughter of African elephants, particularly in the Democratic Republic of Congo, where eyewitness accounts and various imagery has shown that poachers are using military helicopters and they're killing these elephants by the dozens at any one time, herds of elephants there in the Congo. And there may be, or at least the pictures and some of the accusations are, there may be a cooperative effort that may involve a number of African nations in the slaughter of these animals for their tusks. We're going to try to resume our conversation with Dr. Iain Douglas-Hamilton, the founder of Save the Elephants. He's joining us on the phone now from Kenya. This is near and dear to your heart. We talked about the images and how you were describing before the break that Ugandan helicopters were photographed near the carcasses of these animals, but are we able to put two and two, you know, together? I mean, add up the elements here that the Ugandan government in some way is complicit in the killing, the sanctioning of the killing of these animals in the Congo?
No, I don't think that's proven yet. We're waiting for the DNA evidence to see. But this killing of elephants is going on in all four regions of Africa, and it all comes down to the incredible rise in price that we've seen over the last 3 years. And that seems to be driven by the prosperity of China, where people are unaware of the effects of their buying on the elephants.
So, Dr. Douglas-Hamilton, you believe that people are unaware of what it takes or what is being done in order to get these tusks. These tusks are going for thousands of dollars for any one tusk. And it's your belief that those who are purchasing them, whether they're in China or India, that they have no idea the brutality that's involved in order to get those tusks?
I'm not saying everybody, but literally a huge number of surveys come back with the answer that the people buying think that the tusks drop out of the elephants every year, like the antlers off a deer. No, they don't know what is going on, and we really need to share our awareness with the Chinese people, with people in the Far East, to stop the killing and reduce the price and stop all trade in ivory.
So how do you do that? How do you, as a conservationist, as an environmentalist, how do any NGOs successfully try to convey the message of what you're saying in order to get, whether it's Uganda or whether it's Sudan's Janja weed or whether it's the, you know, Lord's Resistant Army, who've also been accused of going in and killing these animals? I mean, what's the leverage that anyone can have to try to get poachers from stopping this exercise?
The only leverage is dropping the price. But in some places, you can also get the local people on side, like we have in northern Kenya, where the poaching is less severe, even though it's worse than it was a few years ago. So we have to stop the end consumer from paying such fantastic prices. It all trickles back down to the poacher, and they get about one-fifth of the price that you have in Beijing. And that is so much higher than any other form of money that they can make.
So somehow you have to cut into the interest of ivory jewelry, ivory ashtrays, ivory bedposts. You have to cut into that interest. And at the same time, you also have to cut into the interest of poachers who are sometimes receiving just a sack of salt, but that's valuable where they are, or sometimes they're getting $400 to kill an elephant or to hand over a tusk. Which is a whole lot of money when some members of the military are just making $100 a month.
Yeah, they're making money, the poachers, and they're usually young men who are not very social, who rob their communities of their wildlife resource by just taking it for themselves. But we're trying all sorts of things, and given the right resources, anti-poaching can work in the field. We're using satellites to track elephants, to track some of the big tuskers in order to protect them. And we need to have that price down. That's the real thing, because on its own, anti-poaching won't work unless you lower the price and lower the demand.
And you mentioned those satellites and those tracking devices, apps, et cetera, to help protect the animals, to protect the elephants. But then don't you also worry that poachers are getting sophisticated, too, and they might be using those satellite tracking devices in order to find the elephants to kill?
No, this is our software, and we only give it out to people that we trust. You can actually see it on Google Earth in near real time, and it really helps the field managers. The poachers can't get it because they don't have the code word.
Okay.
But, we try all these high-tech things, but ultimately it comes down to persuasion. And countries like the United States and China, they've got to take joint leadership to wake the world up that elephants, for good reason, under our noses.
Dr. Iain Douglas-Hamilton, founder and CEO of Save the Elephants, thanks so much for your time and continued best wishes on this effort to try to save the African elephant.